This class we discuss about power supply and the control of power in arc furnaces. The power supply for electric arc furnace is low voltage and high current. Naturally, it is a step down transformer. The power consumption of the arc is very high. Secondary voltage or arc voltage is in the order of 50 volt to 150 volt. We know that heating effect is proportional to I square. Therefore, to achieve higher temperature, we need heavy currents. The secondary current will be of several hundreds of amps for melting the metals. Insulation and safety point of view, the maximum secondary voltage is limited to 275 volt, that is line to line open circuit voltage. The use of low voltage and high current, the electrodes are kept very near to the charge as the arc is small length. To take care of electromechanical and the thermal stresses, a special type of transformer with ruggedness and robustness are required. The transformer used with the arc furnace is oil immersed type. Both core and shell types are used, but shell type is preferred because the second release can be brought out. In the primary side of the transformer, small amount of current is handled because it's a step down transformer. So tapping should be provided for controlling secondary voltage. It is desirable to arrange the transformer in such a way that leads are of shorter length, so that inductance of the lead is reduced. To minimize the skin effect, the shape of the leads to be taken into account. The leads are generally in the form of rectangular strips, paste a few mm apart, are mostly employed as current carrying conductor. Furnace transformer with extended primary winding with the tappings varying for the secondary voltage range 235, 220, 205, 190, 175, 160, that's a 15 volt difference, with the primary connector in delta. This winding range is extended by changing the connection of the primary from delta to star, getting 58%. How you get 58%? 1 by root 3 into 100 is equal to 57.7. Therefore, it is almost equal to 58 voltage from each tap. And we know that in the delta connection, line voltage is equal to phase voltage, line current is equal to root 3 times phase current. But in the case of star connection, line voltage is equal to root 3 times phase voltage, and the line current is equal to phase current. This is the equivalent circuit of furnace transformer. This is primary, this is secondary. Here we are using two electrodes and arc is developed. Arc voltage EA is equal to I into RA, where RA is the arc resistance. RA is the equivalent resistance of the furnace transformer, referred to secondary side. And XT is the equivalent reactance of the furnace transformer, referred to secondary side. RL is the resistance of the load, XL is the reactance of the load, RE is the resistance of the electrode, RA is the arc resistance. Therefore, voltage drop across the arc EA is equal to I into RA. The power input can be varied by raising or lowering the electrodes, resulting in variation of arc resistance RA. By changing the transformer tappings, resulting in variation of the voltage across the furnace. Now we derive the condition for maximum output. We know that R current I is equal to V by Z, where Z is the impedance. Therefore, I is equal to V by root of RT plus RL plus RA the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square. And we know that power loss in the arc is equal to I square into RA, that is equal to V square into RA divided by RT plus RL plus RA the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square. I can write RT plus RL plus RA the whole square is equal to RA plus RT plus RL to the power of whole square. Then this, I consider this is A, this is B. So A square plus B square plus 2A, B. Now A is nothing but RA, B is equal to RT plus RL. Therefore RA square plus RT plus RL the whole square plus 2 into RA into RT plus RL. I substitute in this equation, I square into RA is equal to V square into RA divided by RA square plus RT plus RL the whole square plus 2 into RA into RT plus RL plus XT plus XL the whole square. I divide both sides with RA. Therefore, the RA gets cancelled. Therefore, I square is equal to V square divided by RA plus 2 into RT plus RL plus RT plus RL the whole square divided by RA plus XT plus XL the whole square divided by RA. Power will be maximum when denominator is minimum. Therefore, D by DRA is equal to differentiate RA plus 2 into RT plus RL plus RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square divided by RA is equal to 0. By differentiating, we will get 1 plus 0 minus RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square divided by RA square. That is equal to 0. So simplify the equation. 1 is equal to RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square divided by RA square. Therefore, RA square is equal to RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square. Therefore, RA is equal to root of RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square. And you take capital R is equal to RT plus RL, capital X is equal to XT plus XL, then RA is equal to root of R square plus X square, that is equal to Z impedance. Power loss will be minimum when the arc resistance RA will be numerically equal to the impedance of the whole electrical circuit referred to the secondary side, excluding arc resistance RA. Now we derive power factor and maximum power loss. We know that cos theta is equal to R by Z. R is equal to RA plus RT plus RL. And X is equal to XT plus XL. Therefore, Z is equal to root of RA plus RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square. Substitute in the formula R and Z. Cos theta is equal to RA plus RT plus RL divided by root of. I can rewrite the equation like this. RA plus RT plus RL square can be written as root of RA square plus RT plus RL the whole square plus 2RA into RT plus RL plus XT plus XL the whole square. Now I know the condition for maximum output. RA square is equal to RT plus RL square plus XT plus XL square. Now RT plus RL the whole square plus XT plus XL the whole square is equal to RA square. Simply I substitute in the formula. That is RA plus RT plus RL divided by root of RA square plus 2RA into RT plus RL plus RA square. I simplify cos theta is equal to RA plus RT plus RL divided by root of 2 into RA square plus 2 into RA into RT plus RL. Here 2RA is common, I take it out. Therefore, RA plus RT plus RL divided by root of 2RA into RA plus RT plus RL. Cos theta is equal to RA plus RT plus RL divided by root of 2 into RA plus RT plus RL. Cos square theta is equal to RA plus RT plus RL the whole square divided by 2RA into RA plus RT plus RL. This will get cancelled. Cos square theta is equal to RA plus RT plus RL divided by 2RA. Cos theta is equal to root of RA plus RT plus RL divided by 2RA. I can write cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2 into root of 1 plus RT plus RL divided by RA. Neglecting RT plus RL in comparison with RA, root of 1 is equal to 1. Therefore, cos theta is equal to 1 by root 2. That is equal to 0.707, almost 0.8. However, it is not economical to operate an arc furnace with the primary side power factor under 0.8.